Hey guys, Matt Solm here from Animoca Brands. I'm an ex-Formula 3 and GT3 racer, and I'm here to talk about non-fungible tokens, NFTs, why they're so important, how they work in our motorsport games, and how they'll change the world. If you're new to the world of blockchain gaming, hit that subscribe button with notifications turned on to get more videos explaining key topics and future events. All right, let's get into it. NFTs. You've heard the buzz about this word, and I'm here to break down what the hype is all about. NFT stands for non-fungible token. That's a type of digital item on blockchain. Blockchain is a distributed ledger technology that operates without central authority. Think of blockchain as a really secure and reliable way to keep records, or ledgers. And these records are not under the control of any one person or organization. One important thing to note about blockchain is that it allows digital assets to be scarce or limited in number. You can't make infinite copies of them like you would for a normal file, like a photo, for example. Back to NFTs. NFTs are a type of digital asset provided on blockchain. There are various uses for NFTs. The most popular ones are for collectibles, in-game items, and artwork. So why are NFTs so important? Well, it's because these digital assets have some very interesting characteristics. Fungibility and non-fungibility. Fungibility means interchangeable, a thing that is the same and has equal value as another thing of the same kind. Think of a dollar, a Bitcoin, or a REV token. Your $1, one Bitcoin, or one REV token are just as valuable as the ones I have. They can be split into smaller parts, for example, 20 cents, 0.1 of a Bitcoin, or half a REV. The Bitcoin, REV, and dollar are all fungible. If you're not sure about what REV is, check out my video breaking it down in three simple steps. Non-fungibility is the opposite. When something is non-fungible, it is distinctive and individual, and it cannot be divided into smaller bits. Because of these and other characteristics, a non-fungible item can have rarity and scarcity, which contribute to the value of that item. Rarity and scarcity. Imagine Leonardo da Vinci's famous painting of the Mona Lisa. It's extremely rare. Well, there's only one. It can't be subdivided into smaller parts, and it is incredibly valuable. Or look at this collectible baseball card, which is sold for almost $4 million. These are physical, non-fungible items that are rare and valuable. But now, blockchain technology makes it possible for digital assets to have rarity and scarcity like physical objects. These digital assets are, you guessed it, NFTs. NFTs can be extremely valuable, just like collectibles and artwork in the physical world. The first official Formula One NFT is called the 111. It is a virtual race car for our game F1 Delta Time. This car, a digital item, sold for 415.9 ETH, or roughly $111,000 at the time of sale. More recently, F1 Delta Time auctioned its first racetrack NFT for the record-setting price of $223,000, potentially making it the most expensive NFT ever. Yeah, wow. So why do you need to know about NFTs? The short answer is true digital ownership. True digital ownership. Imagine playing your favorite game. You buy an in-game asset using real money. Or maybe you spent 10 hours grinding to obtain a special item like a magic sword. These are investments of your money and time. If the game shuts down, or if your account is stolen or deleted, all that time and money you've invested in the game is gone instantly. This is because games only give you a limited license to use their property. You never actually own anything in a traditional game. Everything is the property of the company that makes the game, even if you paid for it. On blockchain, however, assets can be truly owned by you, both in and out of the game. No one can ever take blockchain game assets away from you, not even the game operator. If the game shuts down, if you get banned, or if you just get bored of a game, you will still retain ownership and control of all your assets from that game. You can still use those assets in other games or sell or trade them. NFTs enable true digital ownership for gamers. It's basically property rights for digital assets, which makes NFTs important and revolutionary. Revolutionary because NFTs give gamers that same power of ownership that the game companies have kept for themselves since the invention of video games. When you own something, you have the right to make money from it. For example, by renting it to someone else, selling it, using it as collateral, or staking it to generate income. NFTs enable all of this as well, although that's a topic for another day. Our co-founder and chairman, Yatsu, has a fascinating video explaining the subject of digital asset ownership in games. I strongly recommend you check it out if you want to understand how NFTs and property rights for game assets are going to change the world. NFTs in our blockchain race in games. To recap, NFTs can be truly and completely owned by you. With NFTs, you are in control. You can do anything you like with your NFT, including selling it for a potential profit or even using it in another game that supports it. How does this all tie into F1 Delta Time and the other games in the Rev ecosystem? Well, the in-game assets you race with are NFTs. The cars, tires, drivers, helmets, and brakes, and so on, all of these are NFTs with different stats, qualities, and value. When preparing to race, you need to choose the best combination of NFTs for the track as well as weather conditions. How do you get NFTs? There are two ways. From time to time, our motorsport games will have content sales. You can also go to OpenSea.com, links in the description below, to browse what other players are selling. On OpenSea, you can buy NFTs, which you can use in-game, trade on the market, or stake to passively generate income. As I said before, it's completely up to you. There you have it. That was our video on NFTs and true digital ownership. If you found that helpful or learned something new, please give the video a like. If you've still got questions about F1 Delta Time or NFTs, leave us a comment down below. I look forward to seeing you all on track soon with your unique team compositions. Until next time, Rev on.